Please come sit down.
Thank you, sir.
You're already in trade service.
Yes, sir.
What do you do in this service? What does it do?
Sir, our main objective is to facilitate the international trade of India, sir.
Why do you want to make a change now?
Sir, the trade has not that good as it can do.
Coming to IAS, you'll improve the trade.
Okay,
that's
okay.
What you're saying.
No, sir, I thought.
No, that's not an answer.
So I thought that you have tried, but you want to do trade.
Alright, we'll handle it. Now, what are the qualities which you possess which will make you a good citizen?
Sir, I take others' advice into consideration and I try to find the basic problems first, then I go for a solution. I do not rush to things.
Okay, right. Mr. Harpreet,
sir,
you spent 2 years in the border security?
Yes, sir.
Where were you posted?
Sir, I was posted in West Bengal, sir. 24 North 24 Paragonas.
24 Paragonas.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, tell me, in the Northeast,
yes, sir.
The Armed Forces Special Powers Act is in force, and also in some parts of Jammu and Kashmir.
Yes, sir.
What are the powers which are bestowed on the paramilitary forces and the armed forces through this act?
Sir, there are basically two enabling sections in Armed Forces Special Powers Act, Section 4 and Section 6. The one talks about that we have right to search, raid, and even shoot, and the Section 6 protects from the prosecution. Yes, sir.
On the issue of shoot, are you aware of what the Supreme Court has said?
Yes, sir. Sir, in Manipur, there was around 1500 killings.
Yes, yeah.
And Supreme Court has said that they should be investigated by CBI.
They should be investigated by the CBI.
Yes, sir.
Which the CBI is doing.
Yes, sir. I think so.
Yes, CBI is doing, and they have co-opted two persons from the NHRC also on the direction of the Supreme Court.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Right. Now, Nagaland has been witness to insurgency for quite some time.
Yes, sir.
And which are the groups which are operating there?
Sir, can I take a second?
Yeah, sure.
So there were two groups. One was led by Isaac Moiwa and the other was by Kaplan.
Kaplan, that's right. The NSCN.
Yes, sir. National Socialist
Council of
Nagaland. Yes, sir.
Now, they have been demanding this a concept of Greater Nagaland or Greater Nagaland.
Yes, sir.
What does that mean, Greater Nagaland?
Sir, where the Nagas stay, some of the territories are in Myanmar and some of them are in Manipur. The Greater Nagaland, they want to unite all those entities into one single state.
You have said what? There's some portions of Manipur, the hill districts of Manipur.
Manipur, yes, and Myanmar.
Assam. And also Arunachal Pradesh.
Assam.
Naga inhabited areas in Manipur, Assam, and in Arunachal. Three adjoining districts. Three adjoining states,
sir,
to Nagaland. Okay. Right. Now, what was this Kartarpur corridor which has been coming in the media nowadays?
Yes, sir. Sir, the Kartarpur was the place where Guru Nanak Dev Ji spent some of his lifetime here. And it is just 2 or 3 kilometers from the border. When the partition was done, it went to the Pakistan state, and a lot of pilgrims has to go to through Atari border and through proper visa.
So what is required to be built there?
So there needs to be first a corridor of around even 100 meters of breadth and
up to the river also, isn't
it? Yes, sir. A bridge is also.
A bridge has to be built.
Yes, sir.
Which river is that?
Ravi, sir.
Ravi River.
Yes, sir.
So is this a good move?
Yes, sir. I think it's a good move, sir.
Okay. But did the initiative come from Pakistan or was it an Indian initiative?
Sir, there were already demands prevalent in the Punjab. But they did not got something concrete when the Imran Khan government came.
Yeah, they have given this. Right?
Yes.
Okay. Now the government had set up something called aspirational districts.
Yes, sir.
What is the concept behind this?
Sir, previously there were some of the least developed districts, and they were all, and now we have named it into aspirational district. They have potential to grow. It is just a change of perspective.
Okay. How many of them are there?
Sir, 115.
Yes. Out of these, how many were LWE affected districts?
Sorry, sir.
35 of them. 35 are LWE. So what is the mechanism now to monitor what is happening in these districts?
Sir, if you take a second.
Yeah, sure.
So one senior level officer, IAS officers, yes, they have been called Prabhari officers, and they have to coordinate with the someone in the PMO, I'm not really sure.
They will coordinate with a similar officer from the state authority.
Yeah, right? Yes.
And the, who will monitor this? The Niti Aayog.
Niti
Aayog is supposed to monitor this.
I'll read about it, sir.
Yeah. Now this, you know this, controversy around surrounding Cambridge Analytica. Are you aware of that?
No, I've heard of it, sir.
What
yes.
is that? Are you aware?
Yes, sir. In bits. Sir, Cambridge Analytica is a firm which was basically taking out the Facebook data and
Correct.
Checking out the bent of the people, which party they are, or conservatives, which party they want.
Right. Thank you.
Why didn't we go for some rigidity in our constitution?
Sir, because when the constitution was made, there were apprehensions that like Pakistan and Bangladesh had got separated away in the East Pakistan, and there were things that in the situation, there may be other demands as well. So that is why the whole of the India was put into a unit, we decided the Article 1 terms that the unitary structure, the indestructible nation of destructible states.
In terms of amendment to the constitution,
yes,
we
sir.
Have some rigidity.
Yes, sir.
Why do we need that?
Sir, because to avoid the whims and fancies of the parliamentarians for their political gains, we need some kind of stability to work with the constitution. That is why, sir, there is some rigidity there.
Is there a limit to amendment of the constitution?
No.
What is basic structure doctrine?
So basic structure doctrine was a decided Keshavan Bharti case, and it tells that you can amend the constitution a number of times, but it should not alter the basic structure of the constitution. Like the federal scheme, the secularism, and the socialist trend, there are these kind of things.
Are fundamental rights part of the constitution?
Yes, sir.
But in Keshavanand Bharti itself, fundamental right was amended and it was upheld.
No, sir, but it did not change the main broad purpose of the fundamental rights.
Okay, can you tell us about law which prevents people with criminal convicted people from entering electoral politics?
A Representation of People's Act, sir.
What is the provision?
Sir, I'm not aware of the group exactly.
Is there any bar? I don't need the exact section or whatever.
Yes, sir.
Are you aware of Lily Thomas case?
Lily Thomas, no, sir.
Okay, tell us something about the salient features of Right to Education Act.
Right to Education Act talks about providing free of cost education from the age of 6 to 14 years of age.
That is there in Article 21A.
Yes, sir.
So I'm talking of the Act. How is the Act different from the Constitution?
Sir, I'm not sure, sir.
Okay, last. Why is, what is the latest on SYL canal?
Latest, sir, I do not know. But I know what has happened until few months back.
And tell us about that.
Sir, Haryana is demanding water and Punjab is not giving it to it. And
that's
they are
lingering.
And sir.
Okay, thank you.
You've written your hobbies as exploring music.
Yes, ma'am.
So do you sing, do you play an instrument?
No, ma'am. Actually, I wanted to write just exploring songs, but I instead of that,
what it is. So, what do you do when you explore songs?
Ma'am, I actually try to find the songs of my taste. Like some of the songs are from Pakistani and some Farsi songs and some other.
You've written Sufi music.
Yes, ma'am.
And you've written Bhangra and Malwai Gidda.
Yes, ma'am.
What is the difference between the two?
And Bhangra is done by the males, and the Malwai Gidda is also done by the males, but it is actually done by the older men of the village community, and they actually try to have this tire on the women's
so,
lifestyle.
So it's not as vigorous as the Bhangra?
Ma'am, earlier it used to be, in a traditional sense, it is not very vigorous, but presently the youth is coming up with, it was actually dying art form, so now in the college days, and it is getting revived.
Alright. Now, since you're from Punjab, one hears about the drug problem.
Yes, ma'am.
Which is very, very prevalent in
yes,
Punjab. What is the reason?
Ma'am, it is more or less a supply demand problem.
Hmm.
We have abundance of supply because of being...
You have what?
Abundance of supply because Punjab is proximate to the Golden Crescent and Punjab lies on the drug route. So a lot of drugs comes in and the demand is there because the youth is having the money with them.
How do they have the money if they're not
from their parents basically. They do not have them employment but they still got money. They got something to spend upon and it seems like a...
So is anything being done to look into this problem?
Yes ma'am. The special task force was set up and some of the key smugglers were arrested as well. The border security force and is doing to put up a much more effective technological solutions to the man the borders. And I think
we also have some rehabilitation,
rehabilitation centers. Yes ma'am. And also awareness campaign is led by the Punjab Police.
Now you must be aware of the Green Revolution.
Yes ma'am.
What is the second ever Green Revolution?
Ma'am, second green revolution is trying to revolutionize agriculture in an organic and much more environmental friendly way. It is different from the first green revolution.
How?
Because
how is it different?
The first green revolution was basically cereal centric. And because main objective at that time was the food security of the country. Now we have got enough food security compared to...
So are we diversifying the grains also?
Yes ma'am, we are diversifying the grains into pulses and other horticultures. Yes ma'am.
Alright. And we also talk of the Blue Revolution.
Yes,
what is that Blue Revolution?
Ma'am, Blue Revolution is the term to develop our ports and the marine economy.
So what is being done to develop our ports?
Sagarmala project is there, port modernization scheme is also working.
Under
that.
We also have the operation plan. Tell me something about that. What is operation plan?
I'm sorry, I'm not able
to remember. Milk production?
Yes, yes, ma'am. Mm-hmm. Yes, ma'am. Operation flood was with the Amul cooperative and to boost the.
How did it become such a successful cooperative? One of the largest in the country.
Yes, ma'am. I'm not very sure, but their marketing strategy was like that. They marketed it as an international product, led to huge demand of wool. And they also take over the other cooperatives while growing.
Okay, just read it.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, you had electronics and communications.
Yes,
ma'am. So tell me something about drones. What are drones?
Drones are the small aerial vehicles which we can use for many purposes.
What are the purposes?
Like sometimes telemedicine or
okay.
Surveying and all
kinds of things. Do we have any policy for drones? Can anyone just fly a drone?
No, ma'am, there is a limit on drones. Like
why?
Because ma'am, there are many incidents where drones are used for the good causes, like in marriages, they are shooting, and in IPL matches, these kind of drones do not possess any security threat. But when there are bigger drones which fly much higher, they can be a challenge for this threat.
Also, they can be not only a security challenge but privacy.
Even yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
All right. Thank you,
Mr. Harpreet.
Sir,
as an officer from the Indian Trade Service,
sir,
how do you look at India's foreign trade?
Sir, India's foreign trade has not yet reached its potential.
There is huge
scope.
Exports, how are we doing on the exports?
So exports, we have only $300 billion export as of now.
It has been stagnating for last.
Yes,
yes. Virtually stagnating.
Yes.
Very, very marginal.
Yes, sir.
Why is it that India's exports are not competitive in the global market?
So there can be many reasons, sir.
Yeah,
one of them is quality issues. There is not good packaging. No proper marketing is there, and our exporters find difficulty to export because there are a lot of organizations working in, and they find that exporting a product.
What
is
your trade balance?
Trade balance is like 150 billion, sir. 450 billion are in import, and 300 is export.
And CAD?
I'm not sure.
You are not sure. Okay. Imports, what are the main imports?
So the major import is crude oil.
And with prices hardening in the international market, our import bill had also gone up quite a bit.
Yes.
Right. What is the latest price on oil, in price of oil in the international market?
Sir.
It has come down or it has gone up?
So it has come down, but it is now going up. It is around $67.
Under what circumstances you impose countervailing duty?
Sir, when a lot of subsidies are provided in this other country and the products are actually damaging the domestic market.
Can that be done unilaterally or there is a set procedure prescribed under the WTO?
Sir, there is a procedure, yes. Sir.
What kind of?
Sir, I'm not sure.
You answer. Okay, right. SEZs.
Sir.
What is its role and how many SEZs are there in India at present?
I'm not sure.
I'm not sure of the number, but its role you must.
Yes, sir. So they are actually for facilitating the foreign direct investment and for even the local investment into the SEZ, they are deemed foreign territory for the purpose of.
Okay, IFS is one of your service reference. Brexit.
So
that is something to do with your trade service background also.
Yes.
Briefly mention what is this problem and why it is in the.
Sir, Brexit problem has its main major basis in the immigration of a lot of Eastern Europeans into the Britain.
What?
And there was a conservative.
Come to the present. Presently, what is the crisis?
So, present crisis is that the parliamentarians there have not supported the deal of the.
What is this deal?
So, the deal is actually. Excuse me, can I take
a second?
Yes, sir. The deal is, sir, basically to provide a transition period from going out of the European Union.
I think you need to, sir. Okay. Thank you.
Now, what is the unemployment rate in Punjab?
Not sure, sir.
No idea.
No, sir. But it is higher than the rest of the country, sir. Rest of the country has 7% unemployment rate and the Punjab has on higher side, sir. In
no. Check up the figures, don't just give unconfirmed figures.
Sir.
Now, a recent leaked report says 6.1%.
Yes.
And you are going to 7%.
Sir, approximately.
You know that has not been accepted by the government, but even if you accept that report, that 6.1 is what they are saying. So,
yes.
Recheck figures. Okay.
So,
now, you are interested in foreign services as a second choice.
Yes, sir.
Correct? So, what are the goals which foreign policy is trying to achieve? Name two most important goals or objectives of foreign policy. India's foreign policy.
Sir, as of now, the major two foreign policy objectives are one is the permanent seat at United Nations.
Hmm.
And the second is getting the nuclear supplier groups.
Afghanistan,
sir.
It's a country in turmoil, perpetual turmoil.
Yes, sir.
But we are spending money, $3 billion.
Yes, sir.
Huh? Aid we have given.
Yes, sir.
What is so important about Afghanistan that we should...
Sir, the importance of Afghanistan is huge because it will act as a pathway to Central Asia through Chabahar port, basically, once it... So...
There's something else. All that is wishful thinking. There's something else which is worrying us.
Something else I'm not...
Okay. Electronics communications subject?
Yes, sir.
How many people use internet in India?
Do not know the exact figures.
How many people use mobile phones?
Sorry, sir.
No?
No, sir.
Okay. There is a Digital India program.
Yes, sir.
One of its main goals was to connect 250,000 village panchayats. First with optical fiber,
yes,
and then with internet.
Yes, sir.
So, what is the progress in connecting it, in laying the optical fiber to these panchayats? And secondly, providing them with the internet facility. What is the progress?
No, sir. No
idea. No idea?
No, sir.
Now, we close the interview here. I'll give you a little feedback. Most of the questioning, according to us, would be based on your biodata. That is your DAP.
Sir.
Since you are from Punjab, so you have two mother facts about Punjab.
Yes, sir.
Its economy, unemployment, poverty, etc., etc.
Okay, sir.
Second will be public administration.
Yes, sir.
Third would be electronics communication.
Sir.
Fourth, since you are already in a security organization,
yes, sir.
Some questions on these security matters.
Yes, sir.
And so these are the four areas where I think you should focus.
Yes, sir.
Then current affairs.
Sir.
Then constitutional issues and some important judgments of the Supreme Court.
Sir.
These are the 5-6 parameters on which you have very little time. 12th ko hai na?
Yes, sir.
Time to aapke paas kam hai, to yehi 5-6 ghante roz padhi hai aap.
Yes, sir.
Har subject pe 1 ghanta lag gayi. Acha. Newspaper padhiye current affairs ke liye. Bahut carefully padhiye.
Sir.
Start with 1st of February because of the budget.
Budget, yes, sir.
Then some important events have taken place since then.
Yes, sir.
You identify those through the newspapers. Take those cuttings, keep them, read them at least every day before you start your new work. Read those cuttings again and again. You will see how quickly you master these facts.
Yes, sir.
Within 4-5 days, you will be having, at least you will have improved your knowledge by 50%. If you do what I am telling you.
Sir.
Take out two good newspapers, one on, say Financial Express and other Times of India.
Yes,
take out all important cuttings.
Sir.
Start reading them again and again.
Sir.
That is the first thing you should do. Secondly, public administration ke issues humne aapse kafi puche hain. Main aapko thoda sa bata dun. Aapse pucha jaye quality, to you go for basic qualities. Basic qualities are honesty, integrity, hard work, rule of law. You believe in rule of law, professional competence,
yes,
diligence. And you're ready to handle responsibilities and handle crisis.
Sir.
Crisis, right? These are some qualities which are. FSPA Manipur ka hai case.
Yes.
Waisa hi abhi UP ka case aaya hai, 1100 encounter police ne ki hai.
Yes, sir.
That is before the Supreme Court.
Yes, sir.
फिर आपसे पूछा गया था कि रिजिडिटी क्यों है कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन में क्यों लाई गई है आपने बांग्लादेश बात कह दिया कि ये टूटे देयर हैव बीन अटेम्प्ट्स सर्टेन पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज और पर्सनालिटीज टू ब्रेक दिस कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन टू डाइल्यूट सर्टेन बेसिक फीचर्स ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन There have been attempts. What are those? Either to deny the or dilute the fundamental rights.
Yes, sir.
Or to dilute federal structure or independence of judiciary.
Sir.
Therefore, there has been a need. Not because Pakistan and all that.
Yeah.
All these basic concepts came later on. Several years after the constitution was already in force. So, this basic structure concept, they brought the rigidity because of this threat to the basic tenets of the constitution.
Yes, sir.
India will not remain a democracy. India will become like a dictatorship if we do not have these basic features.
Yes,
that is the concept.
Yes.
Remember. So next, limit to amendment in constitution. आप कहते हैं कोई limit नहीं है. Rigidity to hai basic feature ye rigidity
yes sir
ye to limit karta
sir, hai sir but limit I was thinking in the number of times amendment can be
limit is ki aap kar sakte hain ya nahi kar sakte kis cheez ko kar sakte hain kis number se koi matlab nahi hai
yes,
fundamental rights only three rights are part of the constitution of the basic structure 14 19 21 no other remember this Lily Thomas case पढ़ लीजिए criminal in politics
yes sir huh? sir actually I knew something about it but I then
कोई बात नहीं आप पढ़िए अब हम आपको बता रहे हैं आप
ये जय ललित
आप एक डेढ़ घंटा पढ़िए इस पे ये सब constitutional issue है बड़े important हैं Section 8, subsection 4, isme tabdeeli lagi, subsection 4 has been added in the constitution. Achha. पंजाब के बारे में डायरेक्टर पूछा गया था, ये है पैराडॉक्स कि सब अनएम्प्लॉयड भी हैं और पैसे भी हैं उनके पास ड्रग के लिए. तो आप सर यू फाइंड एन आंसर टू दिस, रीड इट केयरफुली. फिर आपने क्या ऑब्जेक्टिव क्या, परमानेंट सीट काउंसिल में और एनएसजी नो दो हैं, टू सिक्योर आवर नेशन अगेंस्ट फॉरेन थ्रेट, दैट इज टू स्ट्रेंथन आवर सिक्योरिटी इंटेग्रिटी, दैट इज द फर्स्ट. एंड सेकेंड इज इकोनॉमिक डेवलपमेंट. All this seed, permanent seed, they come much later, after you have restored these. अच्छा, आज electronics के बारे में हमने आपसे 3-4 सवाल पूछे, आपने कोई भी जवाब नहीं दे पाया. Internet user कितने हैं, mobile phone कितने हैं, digital India का क्या program है, आप इसको पढ़ना आवश्यक है ये सब चीज़. आपको वो मिलेगा बाहर, you will get a DVD in which all these questions and answers, the whole interview has been captured. Read, see it carefully. And start preparing. You have time in 4-5 days. You should do as we are trying to suggest to you.
So,
okay, your bio data, super sawal aane hai, constitutional issues pe, current affairs pe, aur Supreme Court ke important judgments. Aapki baste. Acha. Aur bahut zyada cheezon mein nahi jana. Aur roz padhna hai. Aur padhte rahiye. Us din bhi padh ke jana hai. Aur jis din aapka interview ho, taki koi miss na ho jaye important khabar aapse. Acha. All right. Good luck.
Thank you for
this.
Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss an update.